Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. This is Evergreen Islamic Center. Tonight we will be doing a brief tafsir of juz number 5 of Al-Quran. The same juz will be recited in Tarawih shortly. The name of this juz is Wal Muhsanat, and it is a continuation of Surah An-Nisa. The juz starts with ayat number 24 of Surah An-Nisa. So inshallah we'll start. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. The juz starts with the words wal muhsanatu minan nisaa illa ma malakat aymanukum. So the ayat here 24 is a continuation of the topic from the previous ayat of juz number 4. So in the previous ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that who are those women who are forbidden to marry to? And that was a list of the females that included the mothers and daughters and sisters and nieces and aunts. All those were forbidden to marry. In this juz, the ayat starts with the word wal muhsanatu minan nisa'i. So this is another category of the women that are not permissible to marry. And these are those women who are already married. So the married women cannot be married to another husband, which means a woman cannot have two husbands at the same time. She can marry if she is divorced or if she is widowed, but while she is married to one person, it is not permissible that she marries another person at the same time. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Kitab Allahi alaykum, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordained upon you, wa uhilla lakum ma wara'a dhalikum, besides this, other than all these females that have been listed, they are permissible to marry. How? Antabtagu bi amwalikum, that you seek them, you go and, you know, marry them using your wealth. Muhsinina, the purpose should be to bring them into the wedlock. Ghaira musafihina, not doing secret relationship. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that you have to give them fatuhunna ujurahunna, their bridal gift, which is the mahar, faridatan, it has been ordained upon you. Then we will continue into the next ayat. There, in this surah, from now onward, there are ahkamat after ahkamat, injunctions and injunctions after injunctions from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in this ayat, which is ayat number 29, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is commanding the people, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, O those of you who have believed, La taakulu amwalakum bainakum, do not devour, do not eat up the wealth and the properties of the people among yourselves, bil batili, falsely. Illa an takuna tijaratan, except it be a trade, bainakum, there should be between you, antaradim minkum, by the agreement among yourselves. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says also, wala taqtulu anfusakum, do not kill each other. Inna Allah kana bikum rahima. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very kind, rahim to you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ يَفَلْ ذَلِكَ عُدْوَانًا وَظُلْمًا. So whosoever would do this out of animosity or wrongdoing, فَسَوْفَ نُسْلِهِ نَارًا, then he shall be entering the hellfire. وَكَانَ ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ مَسِيرًا. And this is very easy upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then we go to ayat number 36. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is commanding relationship with others. Wa'budullah, worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, plural. Wala tushriku, and do not associate anyone bihi shay'a, anything with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wabil walidaini ihsana, and be kind to your parents. Wabidhil qurba, and your near relatives. Wal yatama, and the orphans. Wal masakini, and the needy. Wal jari dhil qurba, and a neighbor who is your relative. Wal jaril junubi, and your neighbor who is not your relative and is a stranger. Was sahibi bil jambi, and a traveler who is traveling is a stranger along with you. Wabnis sabil, and one who is on the path. Wama malakat aymanukum, and all those who are under you. Inna allaha la yuhibbu man kana mukhtalan fakhura. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not love those who are arrogant and they brag. Then we'll go to ayat number 43. Again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving the ahkamat here. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, O those of you who have believed, la taqrabu salata wa antum sukara. This ayat was revealed when the alcohol was not completely forbidden to drink. Allah says, do not go close to the worship, to the prayers, salat, wa antum sukara, if you are in the state of intoxication. Later on, it was forbidden. Hatta ta'alamu ma taquluna, until you say, until you know what you are saying, which means you are out of a state of intoxication. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, wala junuban, and if you are not clean, you are in the state of uncleanliness, then don't pray. Illa abiri sabilin, except if you are on a journey. Allah says, hatta taghtasilu, until you clean yourself, you take a bath. Then Allah says, wa in kuntum marda, if you are sick, aw ala safarin, or you are traveling, aw jaa ahadum minkum min al-gha'it, or one of you has come back from the restroom after doing his needs, aw lamastum an-nisa, or if you have spent time with the women, falam tajidu ma'an, if you do not find the water to clean yourself, fatayammamu sa'idan tayyiban, then rub with clean earth. فَمْسَهُوا بِوُجُوهِكُمْ, then do the masah of your faces, وَأَيْدِيكُمْ, and your hands. إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ عَفُوًا غَفُورًا, indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forgiving and ghafoor. Then we will continue in ayat number 57, 58 also. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, it's very important to ponder on this ayat because this is about the trust and the amanat. Allah says, "Inna Allah ya'murukum." Indeed, definitely, Allah Subhanahu wa Taala commands you, "An tu'addul amanati," that you return the trust or the amanat if someone has burdened you with that amanat or given you something to keep. Return ila ahliha, to its owner. وَإِذَا حَكَمْتُمْ بَيْنَ النَّاسِ, and when you judge among the people, أَن تَحْكُمُوا بِالْعَدْلِ, that you do the judgment with the justice. إِنَّ اللَّهَ نِعِمَّا يَعِزُكُمْ بِهِ, indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you best of the advices. إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ سَمِيعًا بَصِيرًا, indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who knows and he watches. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala further is issuing command to the people how to live in a society where there is a leadership. Allah says, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, O those of you who have believed, Ati'u allaha wa ati'u rasula, obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and obey the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa ulul amri minkum, and those who have been made, given the position of leadership over you. So important thing is that as long as they are doing their job with justice, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you atiu, you obey them also. Allah says, fa'in tanazatum, and if you run into any dispute among yourselves, fi shay'in, in anything, farudduhu ilallahi wa rasooli, so return it back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger and try to find out the solution about what the dispute resolved, how it can be resolved with the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and with the ahadith and Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam lifestyle. In kuntum tu'minuna billah, if you are the ones who obey and believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wal yawmil akhir. Then we will continue and we will go to ayat number 77. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking a situation where in the beginning of the Islam, the people who were accepting faith and joining Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, especially in Makkah, they were forbidden to fight back. But later on in Medina, and also when the Muslims became strong, the fighting, striving for the cause of Allah was made mandatory, which some people did not appreciate. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, Alam tara ila alladhina qila lahum kuffu aydiyakum. Have you not seen or come to know about those people who were told to keep their hands tight? And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, wa aqimus salata wa atu zakata, and establish the prayer and giving the charity. Falamma kutiba alayhimul qitalu, when the fighting was ordained upon them, idha fariqum minhum, a group among them, yakhshawna an-nasa, started fearing the people. Ka khashiyatillah, as it should be a fearful activity by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Aw ashadda khashya, or they were worrying or fearing more than Allah. Wa qalu rabbana, and they were saying, oh our Lord, lima katabta alayna al-qital, why have you written down or ordained upon us the fighting? Laula akhartana ila ajalin qareeb, why did you not give us some more time in the nearby? Allah says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is responding to these people. Qul, O Prophet, tell them, matau dunya qaleel, the enjoyment of this world is very little. Wal akhiratu khair, and the hereafter is better, liman ittaqa, whosoever has fear. Wala tujlamuna fatila, and not even a thread equivalent wrong will be done to you. Ainama takunu, wherever you are in this worldly life, don't try to run away from the death. Yudrikkumul mauto, the moth, the death will come and take you. Walau kuntum fi burujim mushayyada, even if you are in lofty towers. Wa in tusibhum hasanatun, and these are some people who, when some good things befall them, yaqulu, they say, hazihi min indillah, this is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa in tusibhum sayyatun, and if some difficulty or musibat befalls upon them, yaqulu hazihi min indik, they start blaming you, O Prophet, that this happened because of you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, qul, say, qul min indillah, everything is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah says, ma asabaka min hasanatin, whatever comes good to you, fa min Allah, that is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa ma asabaka min sayyatin, anything befalls of hurt upon you, from an nafsika, it's coming from your own self because of your deeds. Wa arsalnaka linnasi rasula, and we have sent for to the people a messenger. Wa kafa billahi shahida, and Allah is witness. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is inviting the reader of the Quran by saying in ayat number 82, afala yatadabbaruna al-Quran, don't they ponder, don't they heed, don't they pay attention on the Quran? Walau kana min indi ghairillah, if this was from someone other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, lawajadu fihi ikhtilafan kathira, you would have found a lot of conflict and differences in the Quran. but the Quran doesn't have any of those things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now in ayat number 101 of Surah An-Nisa is showing a command about shortening the salat if you are on a journey. Allah says, وَإِذَا ضَرَبْتُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ, when you are traveling on the land, you are on a journey, فَلَيْسَ عَلَيْكُمْ جُنَاهٌ, there is no sin upon you, أَن تَقْصُرُوا مِنَ الصَّلَاةِ, that you shorten your prayer. Then we will continue. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in ayat number 103 is teaching us, فَإِذَا قَضَيْتُمُ الصَّلَاةَ, when the prayer is done, فَذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, قِيَامًا وَقُعُودًا, while you are standing or sitting down, وَعَلَىٰ جُنُوبِكُمْ, or you are on your side laying down. Allah says, فَإِذَا أَتْمَنْتُمْ, when it becomes peaceful, فَأَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةَ, then establish the prayer. And this is the last part of this ayat, very important. إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ كَانَتْ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ كِتَابًا مَوْقُوتًا. Indeed, the prayer has been made obligatory upon people at their fixed times. The times have been specified by the teaching of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. What time which prayer should be said? That is the word kitabam maquta. Maqut is from waqt, appointed time for the salat. So do not delay salat, do not combine two salats together. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is clearly teaching you. Then we go to ayat number 117. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Inna Allah la yaghfiru an yushrika bihi. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not forgive that shirk should be committed with him. وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ, and he will forgive other than that whatever he wills. Allah says, وَمَنْ يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ, so whosoever is associating a partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَقَدْ ضَلَّ ضَلَالًا بَعِيدًا, he has fallen into far away of misguidance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about some people who worship women. They have made idol and they have given the female names to them. In yad'una min dunihi illa inatha. They do not call other than Allah except some idols or some deities which they have given the female names. And we know quite of those are in India actually. وَيَدْعُونَ إِلَّا شَيْطَانًا مَرِيدًا, and they do not call but shaitan who has been cursed. Allah says, لَعَنَهُ اللَّهُ, Allah has cursed him. وَقَالَ, and he said, shaitan said, لَا تَخِذَنَّ مِنْ عِبَادِكَ نَصِيبًا مَفْرُودًا, O Allah, I will take a portion of among the people of their deeds, and I will go and mislead them and command them, I'll put false desires in them, and they will do certain things to disobey you. So this is the promise of shaitan which he fulfills. Then we will continue. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching us in this ayat, in surah ayat number 135. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu kunu qawwamina bilqist. O those of you who have believed, stand up with justice to bear the witness, to give the shahada. Allah says, and be the shuhada for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, keeping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in front of you when you bear a witness, be true in your witness. Walau ala anfusikum, even if you have to testify against your own selves. Awil walidaini, or even against your parents. Wala qarabina, or against your own relatives. In yakun ghaniyan aw faqiran, be it a poor or a rich. Fallahu awla bihima, Allah is above both of them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, fala tattabi'ul hawa, and do not follow your own desires. Anta'adilu, that you do not do the justice. وَإِنْ تَلْوُوا أَوْ تُغْرِدُوا and do not try to mix up or try to change the witness, the testimony. Very important, keep the testimony as you are a witness of that. Do not try to alter or change or turn away from that. إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرًا Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching what you are doing. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are reaching near the end of this juz, juz number 5, Al-Muhsanat. But the surah continues into the next juz, which is La Yuhibbullah, that will be done tomorrow, inshallah. But we will do a few more ayahs of this juz. And one of the ayat is, says Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very, in a very loving way, inviting people and giving them a very beautiful advice. He's saying, what will Allah gain by punishing you? Very beautifully. Ma yaf'alullahu bi azabikum. What is Allah going to gain? What is going to Allah have? What is going to Allah do by punishing you for no reason? In shakartum, if you are being thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, these words he's using are basically to keep the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala away from you and from us. Allah says, in shakartum, if you are thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa amantum, and you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, only these two things are mentioned. If you practice these two things, and then obviously what Allah commands, you have to practice. But these two things are actually coming from the heart. These are not the physical actions. Shakartum, being thankful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by your tongue. Amantum, that's the other thing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, is believing. And that is a belief of the heart and the mind. If you do these two things, obviously you will be doing rest of the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accordingly. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, then if you do these two things, what will Allah gain by punishing you? He doesn't want to punish you for anything. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ شَاكِرًا عَلِيمًا And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is appreciative if you are thankful to him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is knowledgeable of whatever you do. So inshallah al-aziz, we will stop here. There are many, many other ahkamat in this surah. Very beautifully Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to understand the Quran, to read the Quran, to learn the Quran, and practice what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is commanding us to do. Sadaqallahul azim. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept. Assalamu alaikum. Allah.